I'm John Papa.
And I'm Ward Bell.
And today we're going to learn 5 things about RxJS.
Give me something.
I've heard about Reactive Forms and Angular, and I assume the Reactive's in there for some reason.
Yes, indeed, because when you're typing or interacting with a form, you may want to react to what the user is doing, and Reactive Forms will tell you what the user is doing by sending observables to you inside your component class, and you can use all of those nifty operators to filter, respond, react, twist, do whatever you want as the user is making changes.
So a stream of events in that case could be as they're typing into the input fields.
It could be, or you could say, I want to know when they submitted it, and then I want to say, yes, I'm waking up, and or there was a validation event that was changed, and you want to cause something else to happen. All kinds of things that perhaps are initiated by the user, but express themselves in funny ways you can listen to. Send the request. Go, little request. Out, go. And my request, you know, you send a request out there, and if it loves you, it comes back as a response. And if it doesn't love you, it's gone forever. Yes, John.
HTTP.
Yes.
We're going to use that with RxJS. We use Angular. Yep. Often I have like an Express server or something in the back end for my APIs.
Right.
How do you think about moving to the cloud with this kind of an architecture?
Right. Well, from a client perspective, I don't know where it is. But what I'm discovering as I write my applications is that I'm making lots of little requests to different places to get little focused pieces of information, and then I'm having to coordinate that back. And Azure Functions and serverless Azure applications allow me to think in terms of having lots of little focused sources of data that I can get from and write to. And so I see us just sending requests out to all these different endpoints and then coordinating them with RxJS on the way back.
So in that case, you wouldn't even have to set up a Node Express server on the back end. You could just use the serverless microservices.
Absolutely. And as soon as somebody adds a new one, whether it's me or some colleague adds a new one, bang, I can go out and get that. And it becomes just all part of the rich world of change that is my client application.
It sounds like a good world to live in.
If you put your ear to Azure really close, you can hear it go bang.
I don't think we wanted that in the video. Where could we learn more about RxJS with Angular? Easiest question on the board.
Where can I learn about Azure? And I'm thinking, what from you, John?
Where can we learn more about RxJS and serverless together?
Well, the place for serverless is the Azure Docs. For RxJS, there are places all over the web, but the place that you might want to start would be, if you're an Angular developer, would be the official Angular Docs, where we have a guide about your use of RxJS in Angular.
And you had a little hand in that, didn't you?
I did, but mostly it's Brandon Roberts. He deserves the credit.
Yeah, he did a great job there.
Yes, he did. Fly me to the moon and let me play upon the stars.
I'm John Papa.
And I'm Ward Bell.
And we just learned 5 things about RxJS.